Yarana.
Yarana.
Hello, everybody, and hello, Cherie.
Hi, Carl. Hi, everyone.
It's like a Friday afternoon. It's a long weekend. Although I don't think everybody in the U.S. gets Good Friday off like we do in Canada. Hopefully everybody has the long weekend this weekend. It's not just because we are having a long weekend here with the Tahiti by Carl team, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Good. Not that I have any plans, but nonetheless. We'll still take a long weekend. So
yeah. Long weekends are nice.
Exactly. And I always do some work anyways, but it's still good. So welcome back to the show, everybody. For those of you that are watching live, we appreciate you joining live. And for those of you that are watching this as a saved version later on YouTube or Facebook, primarily YouTube, I think is where most people watch the reruns, but I hope you do enjoy the show. My name's Carl, and this over here is Cherie, and we work for Tahiti by Carl, and along with our colleague Sarah, who's not on the show with us, but what we do is we help take the complexity out of planning and booking customized, memorable Tahitian vacations. So we take all that complexity out of doing these bookings for you, and today what we're going to do is we are going to go through some of our vacation packages that we put together and talk to you about, you know, if you're looking at them, what to look for so you fully understand them, and how you can use them to help get your vacation planning started. So as always, we love comments. We love questions. We love the hellos from everybody just to know who's watching, because we don't know who's watching and we only know how many people. We have no idea who. And today, I have to admit, there's not that many of you here. But that could be because it's right before the Easter weekend. And it could also be that so many of you that join us live all the time, you're already booked. As Liz.
Yes. Hi, Liz.
Hello, Liz. Thank you for joining, as always, every Thursday. Liz, do you set an alarm? You never, ever, ever miss. And I just wonder if you have an alarm set so you catch it on time. You know, there's no PVR. There's no PVR, although it's YouTube. But and we also have a comment here from Judy. Thanks again for joining, Judy. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. And good afternoon. How many days, Judy? Do you have your countdown going here? Both Liz and Judy are booked to go back again. Like I said, the people that watch us live are a lot of our regular, our regular clients. So please join us and ask any questions that you may have and drop comments if you like. And oh, there we go. 55 days, less than 2 months now, Judy. Woohoo. And Liz, I'm sure Liz has her countdown going too. It's a little longer for Liz, but going in her cruise leaves in April or early May, beginning of May. So yeah. Okay. So today, Cherie, what are we talking about?
Vacation. We are talking about all the packages or, variations of what we can put together. They're just ideas. They're, to get you thinking about what you can put together. You can take bits and pieces from each package and make your own.
Yeah.
We love to do the custom itineraries. So these, if you see something that you like and you want to just go with that, that's fine too. But we like to kind of customize to what your dream is.
Yes, exactly. That's why we say browse for ideas, customize for perfection. There's too many times that people buy things online in the travel world, and especially when it's a real dream bucket list trip like Tahiti is, and they see something there and they're like, it's one night here and it's three nights here and it's five nights there. We'll book that. That looks good. Yes. And you don't really know what else you can do, or you don't, customize it with the tours and the activities and to match what it is that you want. So we aren't really looking for people to call us and say, oh, look at that thrill seeker's escape. Book it. We expect you to say, we're looking at your thrill seekers and we love this or love that, but we can't go that long. We need shorter, or we don't want to swim with the whales because I don't swim, or, and then work on it. Like Cherie just said, you can mix and match. Just browse through them and see what you like, what you don't like. But it gives you an idea on pricing is one of the big things. Because if you're starting to plan this trip, a lot of people have no idea what it's going to cost. And these by no means, are the exact pricing because we'll play around with it, right?
Yeah.
So first off, about our packages.
Yeah. So we've priced them out based on high season because that's pretty much, you know, when we would like you to go to the islands and where, when you're going to get the best weather and so on. So high season usually runs from May until November. Sometimes November is considered shoulder season and sometimes not, depending on the resort. So, and then of course, low season is from December to March, and April is considered shoulder season. So the prices, most of the prices on the website, the packages that we've done are based on high season.
Yeah. Yeah. I think we got one. I think maybe we have one we have to update because it's still showing a low season pricing.
Yeah.
But we just kind of decided, like,
yeah,
you know why? You don't want to go down there in February or January if it's going to be possibly the wettest time of year, unless that's when you have to travel or whatever.
Yeah.
But we're trying to do these not so many companies have a marketing people behind it. And they're putting these things together from a marketing perspective to try to make the phone ring.
Yes.
And that is not what we're doing. We want to give you a realistic idea of what your trip's going to cost. So there's no point in looking at a package for low season pricing when you're going to travel in July, which is high season pricing.
Yes.
Because they're not going to be the same. And then you just call and then someone just tries to upsell you and this and that. And that's not what we're all about. We're all about finding out what it is that you want to do. And then let's build that for you. So we're trying to set realistic and reasonable expectations. And that's why we have probably one of the only companies out there putting the higher season pricing on there instead of trying to score you the absolute lowest price just to make you call us.
Yeah, so, for sure. Yeah. And of course, if there are discounts or combo rates or things like that that we can incorporate into your itinerary, we always do that. If they're available, we always incorporate those discounts in, whether it's high season or low season.
Yeah. And then a little bit about the availability and the early booking, just so people understand how we work. You know, we all know if you're booking travel, you can look at a cost of a flight and it can be one thing today, one thing tomorrow, something else tomorrow afternoon, something else the following day. You know, things change in the travel industry, pricing changes. We work primarily off of contracted rates for all of our hotels and all of our tours. But even in this day and age, those can change. So when we put things in there, as the hotel space gets sold out, a lot of the hoteliers will pull our contracted rates and they say, no, you have to go with this pricing instead, which is much higher, or we have to go with the kind of rates that they're selling. And I have seen some of the hotels be 3 times as much money as what our contracted rate is. So when we say it's based upon availability, that's because every week we get updated stop sells from all of these hotels saying, yes, you can do this. No, you can't do this. These rooms are sold out. These rooms, no problem. So when we're working on your packages, we're looking at all of those. So unfortunately, we can't update this website every single week.
Yeah.
And, you know, and sometimes it's like 2 days are sold out and the rest of the week is available. So just know that, you know, the earlier you book, we always preach this, the earlier you book, the better. So we can get you the best, you know, the best rates.
And some of our packages, you'll notice we've based on specific dates. So September, summer, and August. And of course, availability for this July, August, and September is already getting limited. So if you're looking to travel this summer, you know, space might not be what you would hope.
we need to move.
Move quickly.
For sure. Yeah. And then just to comment on the private versus shared, because in our packages, depending on the package, you know, some of the tours that we put in are based on a shared basis. And in French Polynesia, any tours that you want to do, we can do on a private basis as well. Pretty much any tour we can do on a private basis as well. And everybody's got their personal preference. And there are some tours that we offer that are only on private and some that are, you know, a few that are only shared.
Yeah.
But, you know, it makes a difference in the price. So sometimes if you're looking at a package, you think, wow, we love this, but holy, that's expensive. You know, also look at the tours, because if you're looking and it's got the private lagoon tour in there, you know, we might be able to save you, you know, a third of that tour price if we did it on a shared basis versus a course, is a package basis, right?
For sure. And we're currently working on 2024 contracts. Our 2025 contracts will be out in the next few months. And until that point, we can book into 2025 on this year's rates. So if anyone's looking in for 2025, we can certainly get you in on this year's rates so far.
Yeah. The majority, there might be a couple that don't, tours, companies that say it's too early to book, but primarily, international flights, we can't though. International flights are not available until about 11 months prior. But our internal inter-island flights, we don't know the flight schedules yet, but we know enough of the flight schedules as to what islands on what days and assuming things don't change. So, and then we can work off of our contractor rates for all of that. So so we can include the inter-island flights and then 11 months prior, we flag your file and then we talk international flights at that point in time.
Yeah. And the packages do not include international flights. There's just too many variables with the international flights to make it, to include it into a package that, today it's one price, tomorrow it's another price, and so on. So we don't include the international flights, and we like to assist you from your starting point to all the way to Tahiti and back, whereas a lot of companies don't include that domestic flight or the, flight from point A to LA or San Francisco. Mm-hmm. So we like to try and do that for our clients.
Yeah.
Makes it easier.
Yeah, I used to always do, before Cherie was around, we used to always put in the cost of a flight from LA or San Francisco down. But now there's a lot of airline options, Delta, Air France, Air Tahiti, United, and so there are more options. But also, like Cherie just said, bottom line is the majority of the time you don't want to book a flight from Los Angeles to Tahiti and then add on a separate ticket for your connecting flight. Yeah. Remember, if you do two separate tickets and those airlines, either one of them has a schedule change and now you misconnect,
you're on your own.
They are not responsible for re-protecting you. You have to pay to change that flight. I just had a client who did two separate tickets and this is what happened, and it cost him an extra $1,000 to change his domestic flights to match the international flight. So even if it's a little bit more, it is way safer to do it all as one ticket. And of course, when it comes to our packages, we don't know where everybody lives. So we can't price it out, that way. So we've just decided now is like no flight prices are included in the package. Although Cherie, we did make note of kind of the starting rates, right?
Yes. Yeah.
We jotted that down after we went over that today.
Yeah. So if you're talking just the flight from LA or San Francisco to Papeete and back, economy class in the 800 US per person range and Canadian about 1050 Canadian per person range. Yeah. That's kind of a starting point and obviously going up from there. Premium economy around 1850 US per person and 2450 Canadian per person for premium economy starting point, and business class about 4500 US per person and 5800 Canadian, again, a starting point.
Yeah. Price. And the prices for the Tahiti flights are almost always best when you book, when they come out and the availability is good. So
yes,
as the space books up, the price tends to go up on those flights. It's very, very rare that there's a seat sale that goes on that actually brings a price down lower than what it is when they initially.
When they first come out.
So, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then the one thing I want to mention too is if people are watching this, I know we've got the group of you here live, but if people are watching the recorded version, just please note we are recording this right now, March 28th, 2024, because this could sit on the YouTube for a while. So just to make sure expectations are correct, it's always good to look at the dates.
Yeah. 3 years from now, these prices are probably not going to be the same.
a little bit different. So where do you find our packages? So tahitibycarl.com, we have everything on tahitibycarl.com, and then you do the /vacation-packages. So why don't we just give me a minute here? We're going to hop over. We're going to try this. We don't usually do live internet on the live show, but let's see how it goes. I'm just going to remove that top Should I remove that top banner? Sorry, bear with me here one moment because it kind of blocks the... There we go. And then that shows our website. So this is the homepage. And then right across the homepage, you want to go to the vacation packages. And then you click on vacation packages, and this is where you're going to find all of our different packages that you can browse. And we've been working hard this week.
Yes.
I have to admit, these have been well out of date. And the website in places, we need to add more resorts and things. We're a little bit behind on some of this. You guys keep us so busy on the booking side of it. Yeah. We have a hard time doing the marketing side of it. But we've got lots updated here, and we're going to keep working on this next week in the coming weeks here to add more, even more packages to it for all of you that to help kind of browse through. But like we said, browse for ideas, customize for perfection. You know, we don't believe in the cookie cutter package for French Polynesia. It's too important of a trip for you. Over on the right hand side, you can see there's the package type. Now, when you click on this, unfortunately, for whatever reason, it doesn't show you the pull down menu on the screen here. On my screen over here, it does. And so you could select things like honeymoon and romance. You could select active getaways, and then you click search, and then it's going to change the packages to any that we kind of deem as a more active, you know, as a more active getaway. So we'll be uploading more there because the different categories we have is we have active getaways, you know, all-inclusive, which isn't the same as an all-inclusive in, it's not the same as an all-inclusive in the Caribbean and Mexico. I should almost call it all-inclusive, you know? It's like Cabo Grande Cruises, which is all-inclusive except for your shore excursions. The Brando, which is all-inclusive. Motu Now Now, the private island that you can do the buyout on, is all-inclusive. So we have a few properties like that where we can do all-inclusive. We've got a beach lovers category. We've got family fun. We've got honeymoons and romance. Private luxurious. So there's a variety, yachts and cruises. There's a variety of different things. And some of the packages are flagged in, you know, multiple categories, but it just helps if, you know, if you say you're like, wow, we're real beach people, then you can look at our itineraries that we feel are, you know, really for the, you know, for the beach lovers or for the, you know, the yachts and cruisers. So what should we start with, Cherie? We're going to start with the, we're going to walk you through four of our packages probably to give you an idea of what's in them and what to look for when you're looking at the packages so you understand. And we're going to do the thrill seekers, I think we said, right?
Yeah. Yeah. We have been, you know, more and more we get requests from people who want to stay active throughout their trip and they want a loaded itinerary. So by loaded, I mean almost something to do every day. So this is a great example of how we can load up your itinerary and keep you busy every day.
Yeah.
So it's a 10-night duration, and I've chosen Tahiti and Moorea as the two islands that you'd visit, mostly because those two islands offer the most excursions and activities that we can, you know, build your itinerary with. Mm-hmm. So the package starts with 5 nights in Tahiti at the Intercontinental.
Actually, Cherie, sorry, maybe before we jump into it, just because this is the first one.
Yeah.
Let's just explain a little bit more about what they look at here when we're looking at this, because okay. We've got the, you know, this just talks about the package, the graphics,
yeah.
You know, obviously the heading on it, how many nights, and then it's always going to tell you the islands that you visit on the package. There's a description of it here. Here we've noted the international airfare is not included, just because a lot of we used to include it, and just because a lot of people, you know, look for it being included, so we've pulled that out. But I just want to talk a little bit about the pricing so people understand how this works.
Yeah.
So because we work directly with the supplier in French Polynesia, everything we talk with them is priced in euros. Our contracts and everything are in euros. The euro and the French Pacific franc are at a set exchange rate. They never, ever change. So when it's paid, it's actually paid in the local French Pacific franc, but that's always going to be the same as what we quote you in euros. But we know people need to think in their local currency. So it's priced in euros. This package, you know, unless we change the package or things change, it's always going to stay at 6,040 euros per person in euros. And then these two numbers will change based on the current exchange rates. Yeah. So you can see in the US, it's not that bad. Us poor Canadians, our exchange rate isn't so good right now. So it's more expensive for us to go. But I just wanted to explain to people, that's why you see the three different currency. You know, we have some clients that come from Europe. We've got a ton of people from the United States and a lot of Canadians, right? So that's why we price it that way. But the actual, when you actually pay for your package, you like, if you say to us, we want to pay in Canadian, you know, we don't take Canadian dollars because it's being charged from them in Tahiti. The charge will go through in French Pacific francs. Your credit card will exchange it over to Canadian at whatever exchange rate they give, which is the same once you travel and you get down there. You can't have things paid in Canadian dollars or US dollars. It's going to be, you know, it's always going to be the local currency.
Yeah, for sure.
So let's just open this up and then we can get into it. Then I'll let you get back on track here now, Cherie. So
yes,
what do you have in this package? Because you're the one that built this one, so you know.
Okay, so thrill seekers. Yes, so the package will start. We always start with an airport meet and greet, and then we include all the transfers. If you're going to an island that you take a ferry, we include the ferry, the international or the inter-island flights we include if you're going to an island that needs the flight. So those are things that are basic for any of our packages. For this one, I've done 5 nights at the Intercontinental Tahiti in a classic ocean and Moorea view room, which is quite nice. And we try to always include the breakfast as well in all of our room rates. And then in Tahiti, we have a half-day private surf lesson. So this surf lesson can be beginner, it could be intermediate or advanced, whatever you are, we have an instructor for you. And we've also included a half-day shared tour, a hiking tour in the valley. I'm not even gonna attempt that name. Can you pronounce
Ba'u Ta'ua, I would guess, but I'm actually not an expert on that one either. I've never been to that valley, but
that's a tough pronunciation, but very nice for hiking. And a shared full day mountain bike tour, and that's on an e-bike. So Sarah's done this one and she really enjoyed that. And then we have a shared snorkeling tour as well. So a great mix of land and sea activities in Tahiti. So then you'll go across on the
ferry. Well, I just want to say, I love that you put the snorkeling tour in Tahiti because most people don't get out on the lagoon in Tahiti. And it is pretty, you know, it is a pretty lagoon as well. And, you know, I have done a snorkeling tour in Tahiti. And, you know, there's even like an old plane wreck at the bottom of the lagoon. And it's the lagoon shallow enough that you can snorkel over top and you can actually, you know, and you can which is really cool because, you know, usually those things are for divers only, but the water is so clear in Tahiti. And that was one of the things that I got to see when I was snorkeling in Tahiti.
Oh, yeah, that would be good.
Yeah.
That'd be really good.
Okay, sorry, move on.
no problem. So then we take the ferry across to Moorea, and you have 5 nights at the Sofitel in a luxury overwater bungalow. So even though this is an active itinerary and we have something for you every day in Moorea, they're only half-day tours, so you still have a good amount of time to relax on your overwater bungalow and enjoy that as well. So the tours that I've included are the hiking tour to the waterfalls. Again, hard word to pronounce. How about this one, Carl?
Oh, you're challenging me on live camera here. Afari Aitu.
Okay.
Afari Aitu, I think.
Or something like that.
You definitely correct me.
And since this package was based on a September departure, I've included a whale watching excursion. So, of course, that's seasonal, and from August to October is whale watching season. So that might change depending on when you travel, but we've included that in there. And an e-bike tour again in Moorea. And you've done this one, right?
It was amazing. It was really good.
All the way up to Belvedere Point, which is amazing.
And, you know, even though it's going up to Belvedere Point in an e-bike, it's not hard at all.
In that motor, right?
It's not hard at all. If you can ride a bike, you don't have to worry about the exercise side of it. So
yeah, exactly. And then, of course, we've included a half-day snorkeling tour as well in Moorea. So lots of inclusions in this one, and that's kind of why we've called it the thrill seeker, just because if you want to be active and you know, and adventurous.
The half-day share snorkeling in Moorea, you'll get to do the shark and stingrays, which is, you know, again, a bit of a thrill.
It's a classic.
Other thrilling things we could add or change to this too. You know, you can skydive in Tahiti, in Moorea, and Bora Bora. Helicopter tours, the helicopter company is not as reliable as they used to be, so I don't promote those too much, but we got that. You could do diving if you're scuba divers. You could diving and from Tahiti, you can go diving and you sometimes see the tiger sharks, which is a big bucket list thing for some people. Parasailing, horseback riding. Like there's lots of different active things that we can, you know, that we can do and include for people. Hiking the lava tubes in Tahiti is really, really cool as well.
That would be a cool one.
Yeah. So lots of others. And that's what we say. This is just a sample and an idea. And of course, when you get, like, if you're interested in this package and you let us know, we'll talk to you about, you know, okay, well, is this 10 nights a good amount of time, or and customize it and tweak it. But when you get the quote from us, it's completely different than this. It is way more detailed with more pictures, videos, all sorts of information. But just to show you as well, when you're on these pages looking at the packages, if you want to learn more about the resorts that are included, you can click here and it's going to take you to the page just all about the Intercontinental Tahiti or all about the Sofitel. If you like this, I know the button says, I just said to Cherie, we should change the name. You know, it says book this package, and we really don't think, you know, you're going to book this exact package. But, you know, you can click on that and you can fill this in, and then you can add additional notes, right? So say we like this, but we want to, you know, we want to change, you know, change it.
Take out something or put something in or, add a day, take a day away.
Yeah. So, so you can do that. And then if you click on the customize a new package, this takes you to our long form planning form where you can start planning now. And this is a big full itinerary here. It shows the progress across the bottom, but it gives you options for setting your budgets, for how long you're going. It talks about what you're interested in, how many islands, what islands. So lots of great things there. So then we get this form, and then we look at it and we get a better idea as to what it is that you might be looking for. But if you've come from a package like that and you like a package, tell us what the package name is so we have an idea.
Yeah.
And at the end of the planning form, it gives you an option to book a consultation call with us. Just know, before we put it together, any full quotes, we must speak to you by phone to have a call to make sure that we're doing everything, you know? Everything right. We don't have any other suggestions and changes and things like that for you. So you might as well just book the call at the end of the questionnaire, but otherwise you can leave it and we'll come back to you and by email or by phone and work on that. Sorry, let me just get back in here. And then we just put in here too. All of our clients get this after we send this after final payment, right, Cherie?
Yeah.
So after I had to ask that because I forget, because Sarah always does it for me. So this was my COVID project. I wrote this Bon Voyage magazine and put it together in electronic format with lots of lovely pictures and a ton of information. So all of our clients will get a copy of this after we do final payment that just talks about, you know, the locals, the island time, health and safety, staying connected, tours, activities, money, currency, credit cards, you know, getting around the islands, a little bit of tips on speaking Tahitian, all of that sort of stuff. So we give tons of, you know, information to our clients, and that comes after you're all booked with us. It is one of the advantages of working with us, is we're not just here to make a room reservation for you. We care about your trip from start to finish.
Yeah.
Okay, anything else we want to say about the Thrill Seekers package?
I think that's pretty good. That covers it,
eh?
That covers it, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So let me just click on next we were going to talk. We were going to do a cruise.
The best of both worlds. Yeah.
Yeah. So let me go to the yachts and cruise packages. And we were going to review. This is the one, anybody who wants to sail with me, May 2025. I just booked another 3 cabins this week. After, if you didn't see our show last week, you can go back and watch last week. It was all about just the cruise side of it. And our guest lecturer who's coming on board with us as well to talk about the golden era of Hollywood, which is really all... You know,
quite interesting.
Yeah. Yeah. So this is a package that people can go in and look at if you're wondering how much it would cost to do the 10-night cruise, but then also 5 nights, 2 nights before the cruise and 3 nights after the cruise on Moorea. You can have a look there and go through that. Then sorry, I just want to make a note for something I want to follow up on afterwards.
Well, the reason why we call this package a best of both worlds is because it combines a cruise with a land stay. So you're getting to see multiple islands and you're also experiencing that overwater bungalow and you get a pre and post land package. So it is what we consider best of both worlds.
Exactly. So,
yeah.
Because the cruise is amazing, but you don't want to miss out on the overwater bungalow.
Yeah, exactly. So it has a different feel. Like the land experience and the cruise experience has a different feel. Both awesome. And when you combine the two, it's perfect.
The best. Yeah. And that's something that you will know with our packages. You will see all over the place, best of both worlds. So that means you're going to have an overwater bungalow stay and you're going to have a overwater bungalow stay and a cruise included. So then it just depends on the dates, right? So you look at the dates and then we customize, you know, where you do your overwater bungalow stay.
Yeah.
So we thought we'd run through the August 2024 Best of Both Worlds package.
Yeah. To get
an idea of what they're like.
Yeah. So the cruise is August 17th to the 24th is when we have promotional pricing. And we'll go through our list of the different dates that we have promotional pricing on the Paul Gauguin. And then we've combined it with a pre and a post day. Did you want to go through the details?
No, that's okay. Good. Keep going. I got distracted by comments here. Okay.
So we'll start off by you'll arrive in Tahiti and you'll spend 2 nights pre-cruise at the Intercontinental. And in this particular package, we have you in the Ocean and Moorea View room, and that includes your breakfast, of course. And then we've also included a half-day East Coast tour in Tahiti to kind of get you started. If this is your first trip, it'll be a great overview kind of tour of, customs and culture and some key viewing points and waterfalls and things like that. So
yeah, another cool company that we use for that, because especially for when you first arrive and when you're first timers, because they really want to try to show you the Polynesia way of life and what it's like to live on the island. And so it gives you a really good, a good start to the trip, right?
Yeah, for sure. So this cruise is a 7-day Society Islands cruise. So did you want to go through each port of call or do you?
I don't think we need to go into that much detail. We'll run out of time. We do that when people book and stuff, but it's, it's the classic. It's their, call their classic with Huahine. I said, I'm not going to know who it is, but Huahine, Bora Bora, Taha for Motumahana, the private island, and Moorea. So those are your ports that you get to visit. And you get an overnight in Bora Bora, and you get an overnight in Moorea. So you get 2 full days in both of those popular islands. Which is really
and cool. With this package, we've included a lagoon tour in Bora Bora on one of your days, and the food tour in Moorea on one of your days in Moorea. So great excursions off the ship on those 2 days that we've automatically included. Obviously, there's lots of other excursions that we can include, but those are in this package.
Yeah.
And then so after the cruise, you'll come back, the ship will come back to Papeete. From there, this particular package has 3 nights in Bora Bora. So we'll fly you over to Bora Bora and transfer you to Le Bora Bora by Pearl Resorts. And you'll stay in an Otimanu view over water bungalow for 3 nights. So Otimanu is the mountain on the main island of Bora Bora. So great views over the lagoon to the mountains. So really nice. Yeah. And then we've included a jet ski tour there in Bora Bora as well, which is really fun. They take you all the way around the island and make some stops. And so it's really fun.
Yeah, yeah. And anytime out, I always say anytime out on the Bora Bora Lagoon is a good time spent on the Bora Bora Lagoon. So yeah. If you're not jet skiers, we could do a sunset catamaran tour or something, or we could do a snorkeling tour. We could do a wine tasting out on the lagoon. You know, there's different things that we can.
Yeah, lots of options there.
So, yeah, yeah. Excellent. Okay, I'm going to hop over to the comments because I have really fallen behind here. Sorry, folks. But Bradley, that was Judy I just had. Judy was 55 days. Bradley, thanks for joining once again. You're pretty much every week as well. And then I was asking Liz how long until her trip. 399 days, Fiji to Tahiti with Paul Gauguin. So it's going to be a beautiful itinerary.
Yeah,
I think really last week, Liz, I said you should do back-to-backs and you should join me, but I think I should be joining you. I should be going on and go Fiji to Tahiti and then Tahiti on my May 14th sailing. Yeah. And then I was asking Liz how she remembers all the time about the show. And she just said that her brain is programmed for Thursdays at 5 p.m. So,
which is great.
And then Judy's comments came in here. I love the video that you do that goes over the itinerary. That sold me for sure. So when we put together your actual quote and your itineraries for you, we don't just send you something like this to read. We tend to be video people, as you can tell. We make a customized, because I did have somebody this week who didn't realize it was customized and she didn't watch the video. She just thought it was generic and she's watched all of our YouTube videos. And then she realized it's customized. So we do customize a video walking you through your itinerary to explain it all to you. And what I really like about that is if we're on the phone with one of you and there's two of you going or there's two couples going, you don't have to remember everything to tell other people.
Yeah, that's true.
We make the video. We send the video with your quotes. You click on a link. You watch a video. It walks you through your whole package. But you can give that to somebody else. Or if you want a book and you want friends to join you, after you book, then you say, hey, come join us. Look at this, right? And you can just send it to other people. So I'm glad you like that, Judy. I'm really glad you like that because it does take us a lot of time. So, yeah, glad you enjoyed. Liz is agreeing I should join on your cruise. Okay. I have to see how much work I can do from the ship while I'm at sea. focus, but man, that would be a wicked back-to-back. And Ken.
Oh, Ken, yes. Ken's going to be sailing on my group cruise.
Oh, so
in November 2025, yeah. And he has the best of both worlds booked with 2 nights Tahiti and 3 nights in Le Taha at the end, so.
And Ken, I'm going to have to admit, Ken, that is my favorite Best of Both Worlds package. Yeah, is 2 days before the cruise, the 7-day cruise, and 3 days in Taha. Unless, of course, you can extend it to 4 or 5 days in Taha. But I just find Taha is a beautiful place for a post-cruise.
Yeah, so, really. You
know, some people want Bora Bora because Bora Bora is famous. And they want to do the overwater bungalow in Bora Bora. But Taha is so quiet and relaxed. And after the cruise, you tend to be more busy. So then you get out to Taha and it's just like, you know? Yeah. Relax so and nice. Enjoy. So nice. I'm jealous I'm not going to be on that cruise either with
I know it's going to be fun.
Sarah. Okay, that's caught. I'm caught up on the comments now. So let's go back. So that was our Best of Both Worlds.
Yes.
Next, what do we want? How's our time doing? It's 5:40. Sherry, why don't we next just go over instead of four packages, let's just go over three and let's do the.
You want to do the honeymoon?
The honeymoon, yeah. So let me just find the honeymoon package. Sorry, as I look at my other screen. Honeymoon and romance. And what do we have there? We were going to do the 10 nights. The one we were going to go over.
Yeah. So, of course, this could be a 10-night anniversary magic package or a birthday magic package.
Want to go on vacation magic package. Yeah,
exactly. So we do have a lot of honeymooners. So this is a great kind of example of what we could put together for you. So you'll start with one night in Tahiti at the Hilton in an ocean view room. And of course, that will include your breakfast. And then we'll ferry you over to Moorea for 5 nights at the Hilton Moorea Resort. And you'll have a panoramic overwater bungalow there, which is excellent. And of course, there are, if you are on your honeymoon, there are a few amenities that we can request for you. So we'll get those added to your room. And here we've added a few great tours, the food tour, a lagoon tour, of course. That one's a full day and it includes the lunch, and you'll have your lunch on a motu. So really great experience. And a half day nature and culture tour. And then the canoe breakfast is a great way to, and if it does fall on a special occasion, that canoe breakfast is excellent, an excellent way to start the day off.
Yeah. Yeah.
They'll bring your breakfast out to your back porch on your overwater bungalow and set it up all nicely, and you can enjoy your breakfast there. So really great treat.
And just to go back to when we were talking about pricing on these packages as well. So you'll see in this package, we've done overwater bungalows in both places. So for some people, if you need to bring the cost down, you know, we could do here at the Hilton in Moorea, we could do a garden bungalow with a pool instead, right? Yeah. Or there is one category lower, it's called the overwater bungalow, which is a little less money. Or we can upgrade you to the premium panoramic overwater bungalow, which is not that much more money to do the upgrade. But that's where we say, you know, look at these, but don't worry if the price is, you know, what you want. Come back to us and say, okay, we like this, but you know, it's a little out of budget. So how are we going to change this? So do we take nights off? Do we change room categories? Do we change resorts?
You know? And obviously we've loaded it up with lots of tours. So that's another way that we can pare back as well.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So then after Moorea, we'll fly you over to Bora Bora for 4 nights at the Conrad Anui. And that's in a deluxe overwater bungalow or overwater villa with a pool, private plunge pool. So that's a nice special treat too.
Yeah.
And then we've also included in Bora Bora a lagoon tour, which is, you know, one of our favorite ones that we like to put in there. It's the private tour, and you'll go to the motu for lunch again, have your feet in the water, and really, really special excursion there.
Yeah.
And then a romantic beach dinner, which is a nice way to celebrate again.
Yeah. Very, very special, the romantic dinners for honeymooners. And the Conrad, actually, I mean, we've put in the romantic beach dinner, but the Conrad actually has an incredible romantic dinner up at the top at the spa. And you get views of Mount Otumanu. So we could do a romantic dinner there. Nice. Or if it's in budget, the ultimate is you do the romantic dinner on Motu Tapu, which is a private motu. And it is one of the most beautiful motus in all of Bora Bora. And they actually can do a lunch or a dinner over there. But it does really increase the cost, but it's like, it's pretty wow. Yeah. Excellent. And of course, all transfers and everything. And then you get the guides and all that other stuff that we've mentioned. And again, it's based on high season, high season pricing.
Yeah.
And so that's just a sample of one of our honeymoon packages. So, So once again, you go to our website and you go to the vacation packages. Now, we did want to show you because we said we've got the best of both worlds. Just so everybody's clear, let me just go back here to the presentation. So with the best of both worlds, we can build that around any cruise, really. We can do any cruise. We can add the pre and post and then also sell you the cruise in between. That's not a problem. If you already have your cruise booked and you just want one or two nights, we don't do that. It's a minimum of 4 nights, right? And we only do full packages with your we don't care about the international flights if you want to do that on your own. But from the time you land to the time you leave, we're taking care of everything. You know, we're taking care of everything in between. But if you see a cruise that you want to do that's not something that we've got, we can always do that. But then we also wanted to do, because I think a lot of you that watch this show on a regular basis know, you know, we love Paul Gauguin, and and Liz actually said, here, I'm sure they can set an office up for me if I want to go away for I want to go away for more than a month.
For sure.
Which would be nice. But what we do is we have promotional dates that we set up every single year with Paul Gauguin Cruise Lines, and our pricing can be a huge savings for you. And so we just want to review some of the key dates that we can build out the best of both worlds packages for you. So in 2024, the April 6th sailing, which is coming super soon, is sold out. May 4th, which is still coming super soon. But if anybody feels the need for a last minute getaway, we can still do May 4th. It was at what, 91% occupancy? We checked today. Yeah.
I think there was a few balcony, or like a couple balcony cabins left.
Yeah.
I think it was in the C and B categories.
Yeah. Okay. And the one thing to keep in mind too, when we say that the cruise has space for some of these, sometimes getting the land can be challenging as well. So we, you know, you're always best to book in advance. But if you look at the savings on this one, it'll be, I don't know exactly what it is right now, but if you compare our pricing to Paul Gauguin's pricing, if you were to book it directly, we're thousands cheaper per person. So so that's going to be the May 4th. We've got August 17th doing the seven-night Moor Society Islands in Tahiti. That one's got a bit of space, say 76%. 76% occupancy on that one.
Yeah. I think, again, it's the balcony cabins that are left.
Mm-hmm. Which is good.
Yeah, which is good. Yeah.
I mean, that's always the case that the cheapest and the best.
Yeah, they get
almost always sell out first.
Yeah.
Right. For people that are just stretching their budget to get on there, then there those ones go. And for those people that want the owner's suites and the grand suites, which are amazing, you know, and very, very limited, one owner suite, a couple grand suites, you know, they disappear as well. So
yeah.
Sure. And then we've got October 9th doing the 10 night society in Tuamotu's. And that itinerary with that one's at 85% for that one.
85, yeah.
So you can see 2024 with the cruise lines, you know, very, very booked up, right? We're approaching sellouts for all of those. And as we are getting closer with the, you know, with the hotel space as well, typically over the peak season, the rooms for the resorts will sell out completely.
Yeah.
2025, we have lots to offer you in 2025. Yeah.
2025. So
starting with my cruise.
Yeah, that's your one.
The cruise before my cruise, you can join Liz. Yeah. If you want to do the Fiji to Tahiti, we don't have the promotional rates on that. Liz was smart. She booked like the day or 2 days after the pricing first came out. So she got the best value there. So May 14th. So I will be on board that sailing. So like I say, we've got three more couples that just joined this week. That one is at 52% occupancy as of today. Last week it was at 50%, and that doesn't include the three cabins I just sold. So that's going to jump up.
That'll jump up. Yeah.
That'll jump up even higher because I'm still waiting for the confirmations to come through. So, I would love to have people on board. Love to get to actually know clients and cruise with my clients. So if you're interested, please reach out and please watch last week's show as well, because it was all just on that sailing.
Yeah.
So and then
June 14th, we have a seven-night TV and Society Islands. I think the space is pretty good on that one.
55% sold out, though, already.
Is it already 55? Yeah, okay.
55% on that one.
Okay, wow. So that's pretty. And then August 30th is Moor Society Islands in Tahiti, seven-night again.
Lots of space there. That one was at 17%. So that one, I don't know why that one's not selling as much. So lots of space still on that one.
That would be a great one for whale watching stuff.
Yeah. Perfect whale watching time for sure.
And then we have September 27th, which is 11 night Cook Islands and Society Islands sailing.
And that was at 27% occupancy, so still lots of space on those. So you can see 2025. It's funny, actually, when I look at all of 2025, there's a lot of them that are like 50%, just under 50, just over 50% sold out. And then there's a lot of others that are, you know, that are like this around 25% sold out.
And then we have October 18th, which again is a 7-night More Society Islands in Tahiti sailing. And I think that one's pretty wide open as well.
Yeah, 24% on that one. So lots of space there.
And then October 25th is the 14-night Marquesas Tuamotus and Society Islands sailing.
And this one's more booked up though.
Yeah, I bet. And then November 8th is my sailing. And that's the 7-day Society Islands.
Which is also getting very booked up, eh?
We're almost 50%, right?
Yeah, almost 50% sold out for November 2025, not 2024. Yeah. We're not even at, but 2025. Yeah. And that's because the pricing is so good on that. So it's, definitely that one. And that 14-night Marquesas Tuamotu sailing, that one is definitely going to sell out as well. The Marquesas Islands always sells out. So if you are interested in the Marquesas Islands, reach out to us soon. If you're interested in the best price of the whole 2024-2025 season, we have it, and it's sailing with Cherie and Sarah. Sarah's going to be on board with their mom, Cherie with her husband, November 8th. But that really is, I mean, do you remember what the rates start at, Cherie? Actually, I have here.
Like the $3,000 range.
the November 8th, I mean, the least expensive cabin is $2,840. It's ridiculously cheap. The least expensive balcony, is Category D still available? Do you know, or is it sold out?
The D, I think it's sold out.
I think the D is sold out. So the Category C, which is would be the least expensive balcony, is going to be $4,370 US for the 7 nights. So really good pricing there. Or my favorite Category B is $5,560. So that's,
which is great for a butler.
And I think that was it. Sorry, I just go back. So that was it for those are our sort of key dates, you know, if you're looking at sailing. And we won't get into why Pogogam versus some of the other cruise lines, because we've done that a lot. But if you go back on our YouTube channel, there's a whole playlist of Pogogam videos. We have anybody that's cruising that's booked on the Pogogam. If you haven't seen, I keep clicking the wrong button. I try to go back. If you haven't seen the Pogogam, we have a really popular video on YouTube that we did with our sales rep, Vicky, where we did a deck by deck walkthrough. We basically started at the top of the ship and we talked about everything that's on this deck and then go down, everything that's on this deck, and then ding, 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 ding. And we kind of talk you through the whole ship, which is great. And a great one to watch before you, before you sail.
You'll know where to go.
Exactly. So. Jeff, welcome to the show, Jeff. Karen's with you. Can't wait for 2025. Jeff, I need to make sure you guys got the pre-post bundle that I sent you after we spoke last time. So I hope you did get that, but we'll double check and follow up on that. So they're joining me. And then and the October 25, Liz is a fan of the Marquesas for sure. So it's a great itinerary. Yeah. It is a great itinerary. Liz went on the Aranui when she did it, which really is not as luxurious as Pogogam, but an amazing way to see the Marquesas Islands too. So you can always talk to us about that. So excellent. Jeff got the itinerary. Just wanted to make sure, no rush, Jeff. So planning his best of both worlds, pre-post cruise. So
nice.
Yeah. So how do you book if you're interested in any of these, learning more? There's this super huge long link. It starts off as calendly.com. this is what we call our it's what we call our round robin link. So when you you can't click here when it's on YouTube, but the link is it's on our website, it's on our YouTube, it's on our Facebook. but that's going to take you to this. So we're going to try this again to close that. Ugh, it did the same thing. Doesn't matter. live, the choice of live. I was trying to click on that. I was trying to click on the thing that comes up saying I understand about privacy, but we respect your privacy, but it won't get rid of it. Every time I do, it goes back.
Maybe so. The little X in the corner.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Maybe I do that. Let's see. Oh, there we go. but if you type in this long link or you find it in our bios, it's on our website too in the About Us page. This is going to take you to a calendar. This calendar is combined availability for Cherie and I, because we're the ones that do the planning. Sarah's behind the scenes help. But so you can click on here, and if you want to have a consultation call on the Friday and you need 2 p.m. and Friday at 2 p.m. is available, you just click on it and it's going to block off either Cherie's calendar or my calendar. And then we'll do a Zoom call or we'll do a phone call with you for a half an hour to talk about your trip. So the more information we know beforehand is great. But if you just book a call and we get on a cold call, yeah, it's not a problem too. We can handle it. So
for sure.
So that's, yeah, one of the good ways to book. But of course, you've got all the packages. Stay tuned on the packages. We promise we're going to get more. We are on track now for that. So we will get lots more loaded up there. And if there's any last minute questions, please type them in. Otherwise, yes, we are wrapping up here just kind of in the nick of time. I like to keep it under an hour, and we're at 57 minutes. So thank you all for joining us once again for another Tahitian Moment Live. We will be back again next Thursday. We try to do this every Thursday at 5 p.m. Eastern time. And all of the past ones, of course, are on the YouTube channel. So so you can browse through everything. There's a wealth of information on there. If you're on the YouTube, make sure you click the subscribe button and then ring that little bell, and then you'll get notification when we go live. So you don't have to have the super memory that Liz has. You can just, you can have your phone tell you TD by Carl's going live, and then you just click on it and you can watch. So it makes it a little bit easier. But thank you, Liz. You guys have a great Easter too. You and Sylvan, I hope you have a fantastic Easter. And same with everybody else, whether you're working tomorrow or not working tomorrow. Have a great weekend. Have a great long weekend. Have a good Easter. I hope everybody celebrates with family, friends, whatever you may have planned. And we will catch you all again next week. As they say in Tahiti, goodbye. They say, nana.
Nana.